Ring to We're here for you, Lord Jesus, because we love you so much. We love you so much, God. Jesus. Sing a song, dear.
Thank you.
Here's what I want to do. We're not quite done with this. But I want you to be able to get closer together. I don't want anybody being far apart from the next person, because the Bible says that we're supposed to gather together, that we're supposed to have one voice, that we're supposed to join each other as the body of Christ. So we come to church and we sit comfortably. I don't want you to be comfortable today. I want you to be a little uncomfortable today. I want you to have to be up close and personal with each other so that together we can touch him personally. Does that make sense? All right, I don't see a lot of movement here. All right, move. You know, those of you, how many of you consider yourself real worshipers of God? Okay, if you consider yourself that, I want you to come to the front. Just come to the front. I mean, maybe you don't know what that means. It's okay if you don't feel like it. Come into the front. If you don't understand, that's fine. But this is what we're going to do. I'm not trying to put anybody on the spot that didn't come. I'm just saying, this is what I know the Lord is desiring today, okay? So now, those that are still back in your seats, you have to sing even louder so that you can push it to the front. And those at the front, we're going to push it to heaven. Amen?
Yes.
God wants to do something special here today. And I want you to prepare your hearts to receive from Him today. I want you to get ready for Him to manifest His glory to you, His presence to you. Something special is here for you today. Something very special is here for you today. However you've been in the past, you have the ability to change into something different today. You have the ability to come face to face with Him today, but it only happens in us praising Him, in us entering into His presence and into His courts with praise. Amen. And so from deep within you, there has to be a getting away. Like, okay, now you're up against each other. You're closer than you were, but I want you to focus on Him. But I want you to hear the voices of the other people that are joining in the chorus here and in heaven that are magnifying His name. Because it's in His glory, it's in His presence that everything shifts, everything changes, everything becomes new. This is your opportunity to leave the old behind and to enter into a new place in Him today. So from the inside of you, with blocking out any other thing except for Him, just forget about what's going on. Just only think about, He's no longer the baby in a manger. We're so happy He came. We're so happy He came. But now He's seated at the right hand of the Father. Now He is the King of Kings and He is the Lord of Lords. Now He is interceding for us. Now He is making a way for other people. Now He is praying for things to change. He is praying for you. He's praying for me. And we are going to praise Him for who He is. We are going to praise Him for what He's done. We are going to set our focus upon Him and our gaze upon His eyes. We are going to grab a hold of the hem of His garment, and we are not leaving until we get what He has desired for us to receive today. Okay, let's begin.
Yeah.
Father God. this is a word for both of you. Because I saw you in the spirit. Where's your son? Oh, there he is. Come. So this is a family prophecy for you. The Lord said that you didn't know. You didn't know how to enter into this place before. You came and you learned and you became more and more hungry. And the Lord said, this is a new season for you to experience me. He said, this is not going to be just head knowledge and joy, but you're going to experience who I am. It's a different season for you. It's a different season for you. It's a different season for you. And the Lord says you're going to know him in the way you've never known him, that you're going to become more like him. You're going to represent him well. And the Lord says that the things that the world has tried to stamp on this family, it is going to change exponentially. The stamp is changing. It is going to change into they know who they serve. They know their God. And he is going to do mighty things through you, even you. Yes, even you. Sweet, sweet, sweet spirit, sweet spirit of God. New level, different level, right now, in Jesus' name. I stir up the waters. I stir up the rivers on the inside of her. We won't let them be silent. We won't let them be silent. Everything in her voice, everything in her movements, they glorify you. They glorify you. Rishi, see, here in your presence, Lord, here as we praise you. Keep praising. Here as we praise you, Lord, this is where we find you. This is where we find the relief we've been looking for. Come on, baby, you want it. How much do you want? All of it? Part of it? Then you gotta forget about everybody else. This is you and him. He's been waiting. He's waiting for you every single time. He never stops waiting to see you. He never stops waiting to hear your voice in worship. He loves you so much. It's your turn to love him back. You get to love him back. Worship. Come on, pray with me. That's how you stir it up. That's how you stir it up. She needs to let go of the frustration, whatever frustration. Okay. New level, Lord, a new level, God. We release a new level within her. That's a new day, it's a new time. Oh, you're going to have to fight for it a little. But that's okay, you're a fighter. fighter. God has put a warrior on the inside of you, but it needs to come out for the right things. Lord, I anoint her. I anoint her with the oil of being a warrior for you, Lord. I thank you, Jesus. I need anointing oil. I need an oil. That presence, Lord, your holy presence, your holy presence, your holy presence, your holy presence, Lord. Oriniana la maradiero de Bresho, Siria de Prote Gresho, Sibro de Bresho, Sigresho, the oil, the holy oil of his presence. Receive it, receive it. There you go. Thank you, God. Yes. Spirit to spirit. That's how you win. That's how you win. Already where to go. The Lord gave me a word for both of you during worship. And he said that he's melting you together like never before. And he said, everyone looks at Danielle's beautiful hands and her beautiful voice, but the Lord said, I'm putting a trumpet on the inside of you. And he said, you're not gonna be relegated hiding behind the keyboard anymore. He's pulling you out to the front. It's a new season for you. And he said, you're gonna have that voice arise and you won't be able to be silent. And the Lord says, I'm filling your voice with revelations. That only come from heaven because you've taken the time to fill you up in worship for me. And the Lord said, you rely on Pharaoh. You rely on his gifts to be the voice. But the Lord said, no. You both have a purpose, but it's better together than separate. And the Lord says, it's been good to see how you've affected one another. It's made me happy. But it's time to melt. It's time to melt. I see s'mores. I think God's so funny. I see s'mores and how he takes the sweet and he squishes it until it comes and drips out the sides. And the Lord says, that's what he's doing. He's taken the word and he's taken the ability and he's taken the sweetness and he's smashing you two together to be a representation of him on this earth. And the Lord says, Pharaoh, this is a new place for you where you recognize the work isn't the mission, although you are a worker. The mission is to love him entirely. And the Lord says, I'm drawing you both into this place where you can't come out. The Lord says, I'm going to render you helpless. I'm going to render you to a puddle. I'm going to render you both until there's nothing left but a puddle on the floor where you know me in a way you've never known me. And he said, and you know me well, but you haven't even begun to know me in the place where I'm taking you. And the Lord said, when this occurs, you can't come out of it. You have to stay. You have to stay and you have to be in such a place where you don't care. You don't care, and you don't care what the other one is doing or saying, because it'll be that seamless oneness that I have meant for you all along. And the Lord said, then the power will come. He said, the presence has to come before the power comes. You know how to reach my heart. You both know how to reach my heart. Reach me together, and the power will flow. And the desires that you have are going to come to pass. Pharaoh, there's miracles that are going to come to you and through you. You have prayed for many people, but now it's going to start manifesting. And Danielle, you are going to be a voice to those who are broken. You are the depiction of Isaiah 61 to the broken, to the vessels that are waiting for somebody to open the prison doors. And so there you go. So I need a mic. I need an extra mic. Are you guys holding steady over here? Are you praising the Lord? Are you keeping focused? We got to keep our hearts before him. Okay, I want you to start, Danielle, because I don't want you tagging off of him. I want you to start, and I want you to tell the Lord why we worship him. Why do we worship him with words? Why do we worship him? Jesus. I understand. We behold the Lamb. Yeah. We behold the Lamb who was slain before the foundation of the earth. The Lamb who was slain, the holy, pure, precious Lamb of God that was slain for us. He was slain for us. You were slain to redeem us to God, to redeem us to our Father, the most undeserving ones. You paid the price, the most deserving one, the most worthy one, the most deserving one. God, you have done great things for us. You've done great things for us.
If all the angels, all the angels know to bow before your throne.
Yeah.
All the angels know to sing with a loud voice. Then what are we doing? If all creation knows to praise Him with everything, then what are we doing? You are too deserving of our praise, God. You're too deserving for us to be quiet. You're too deserving for us to be silent.
Yes, Lord.
For the whole earth is full of your glory. All the earth declares your goodness, your greatness, and your glory.
We join with the angels and we declare, holy, holy, holy are you, Lord, worthy of our praises, worthy of our sacrifice of praise, Lord. We lift your name up. We lift your name up. We lift your name up, Jesus. The first, the last, the one who began, the one who was at the beginning, the one who will be at the end, the one who is all in between. We worship you. We worship you. We choose you. We choose you. We choose to worship you wholeheartedly with everything. We choose you. We choose you. We choose you. Over everything else. Over everybody else. We recognize your worth, Lord. We recognize your worth. You are valuable to us, Lord. Okay. I want you to prophesy out what you're feeling on the inside. Prophesy it out, Pharaoh. You know what he's saying. Do it.
I am bringing my spirit into the earth to release the revelation of Jesus to a people who need a revelation of Jesus.
Come on.
I am taking a people on a journey into encounter with me that will cause there to be a transformation like we have not seen in history. There is a journey that is beginning and is launching even as you go into 2019. There is a journey that has begun that is causing you to see Jesus for who he really is, to see the Son of God high and lifted up, to have a revelation of him through the unveiling power of the Holy Spirit. You will no longer be on a journey of your own demise. You will no longer be on a journey of your own making. You will no longer be on a journey of your own agenda. For my kingdom is coming and my will is being done on earth as it is being done in heaven right now. And the thing that you have cried for, and the thing that you have sought for, and the things that you have heard about are coming to the earth, and they are coming to the earth through you, because I declared it to be so, and what I say is accomplished. My word never returns to me void. So know that the power of my word and the power of my promise is at work, and it is coming, and it is coming to bring the fruition that you have been crying for. So keep crying, so keep seeking, so keep asking, and I tell you, you will not be disappointed in me, for I am the one. one that you are searching for. I am the one that you are longing for.
Yes,
I am the one.
Yes, yes.
I am the one. I am the one.
So Lord, I seal their oneness like never before, Lord. The seamless oneness between them and between you as one, Lord. And I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for rocketing them up. Rocketing them up into the heavenlies and bringing down what they see and being able to verbalize it for all of us to partake of, Lord. I thank you for it. I thank you for it, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And the Lord says, I hear your prayers. Of course I hear your prayers. Of course I hear your pleas. Of course I see you praising me and worshiping me and honoring me and lifting me up and showing me your heart and your soul and sharing with my son everything that we've done for you. And of course I hear you. I hear your silent prayers that are only in your hearts. I hear your tiniest little voice that's only in your head. I hear the words coming out of your mouth. I see the expression on your face. I understand the wants in your heart. I understand the needs in your head. I understand all of you and everything as you are my creation and you are my love. And you are my family, and I hear you, and I hear you, and I hear you, and I never grow weary of hearing you. I never grow weary of hearing your praise. I never grow weary of praying with you. I never grow weary of praying with you. I never grow weary. I never grow weary of saying yes and amen. I never grow weary of the blessings pouring out from my throne. I never grow weary of the salvations coming to heaven over and over and over. I never grow weary. I never grow weary. I never grow weary of your prayers. I never grow weary of your needs. I hear you. I hear you. I hear you. I hear you in my answer, my child. My answer, my love, my answer, my bride, is yes, yes, and amen. Lord, we lift up our prayers to you this morning, God, and we know that you hear us, God. We know that you're watching over us, God. We know that your hand is upon us, God. We know that you are looking down on us and dwell inside us, God. We know, God, because you've told us, and we can feel your presence, God. We can feel your presence, God, and we've seen the blessings. We've seen the answered prayers. We've seen your hand on the people around us, God. We've seen what you've done for us and our brothers and sisters, God. We've seen it, God. We thank you, God. We thank you, God, with all that we can say thank you with, God. With every cell of our being, God. With every part of us, Lord. With every piece of us, God, we cry out our thank yous to you, God, our praise to you, God, our worship to you, God. And we thank you especially during this time, God. Especially during this time, God, when you came to earth, God. When you came to earth, God, we thank you, God, in Jesus' mighty name, in your mighty name. Amen.
Oh, my beloved, how I desire you, how I desire you. If you only knew how I desire you, my beloved, prepare yourself, pure, holy, righteous, prepare yourself, Prepare yourself, my beloved. I desire you. I desire to be with you. I gave it all. I give it all to be with you. You want to be with me? You want to be with me? You say you want to be with me. You need to desire me. You need to desire me above all things. Every moment, every minute, you need to prepare yourself, not be distracted. You need to prepare yourself and not be stained. You need to prepare yourself. Strive to be holy. Strive to be perfect, pure and clean, to give yourself to me. I gave it all already. You have it all. I've given it all to you. I've given it all. There's nothing more to give. I've given it all. All you need is to receive it and prepare yourself. Just let those things to the side. Leave those things to the side. Leave those things. I will care for you. I care for you. I gave it all. Do you not know I gave it all for you? I do care. I do care about your pain. I do care about your hurt. But for me to care of that, you need to come close. Come close. Not just for a moment. Don't come visit. I don't want you to come visit. I don't want to be a roommate with you. I want to be a lover with you. I want to be connected always with you. I want you to come close. Come close to feel my heart, to know what I'm thinking, to be my mouthpiece, to want to be with me. I want to be with you. Do you not understand? I'm not judging you. I'm not mad at you. I'm not disappointed at you. I desire you, my beloved. If you only knew my love for you, if you only knew, just allow yourself, allow me to love you, allow me to hug you, allow me to come close to you. I'm always pursuing you. Do you not see? Do you not see throughout your life? I've preserved you. I've given you life. I've given you the things you've asked for. I've given you the things you need. But I desire to be with you. I want your heart to be after mine. I want you to pursue me and everything that you do. I want everything that you do to be about me. And you'll see the great things that we're going to do together. But it's not because of the things we're going to do together. It's not because of the miracles you're going to be able to perform in my name. But it's because of our intimacy together. Do you not know? Do you not know? Well, if you don't, I have it for you. I have the knowledge. I have it. Just come close.
Coming your way. The instruction is this for them. I have been with them when they cried out for generations, and it was real. But we can't have what his desires are for us to be able to bring forth on the earth until our desire is first for him. And this is what it sounds like. I long for you, and I desire you in the deepest place. And I am so sorry, Lord, that I haven't spent the time with you, crying out, Lord, and giving you everything that I have in me, Lord, that I want to give you. Oh, God.
I need you. I desire you, Lord. I desire to spend all my time with you, Lord. I desire to be one with you, Lord, from the innermost part of my being, Lord. I desire you to lead my day, Lord. I desire you to lead my thoughts, Lord. I desire you to lead every decision I have, Lord. I desire your love. I desire your relationship. I desire intimacy with you. I desire all of you. I desire your heart. I desire your compassion. I desire your love, Lord. I desire your holiness. I desire your purity, Lord. I desire all of you. And I desire it for my household. I desire it for the generations, Lord. I desire it for the youth, Lord. I desire it for your glory. I love you. And I want you in every part of my life.
Stevie, you're pretty much.
Lord, I know you. And I know that you know me. And I'm so grateful that you've brought me to this place. You met me when I was floundering, when I was alone and I was confused. And you showed me the one basic truth, Lord, that you are my daddy. That despite whatever I see, whatever I go through, that you're my daddy. That you love me, that you love me, that you love me. That you care for me, that you're proud of me. That you're affectionate for me, that your affections are for me. And Lord, that just gives me so much confidence. I wake up every day just wanting to profess you, just wanting to make you known in this world. You're my reason, you're my hope. You're my desire, you're my passion. I recognize that the air that I breathe is yours, and that it's through your mercy and your grace and your love for me that I get to breathe. And I'm so appreciative of that, Lord. And Father, it's my desire that the way that I know you, the way that you've brought me to a place to know you, and in such a deep and personal way, not a God that's distant and far off, but a God that's lip to lip with me and cheek to cheek with me, that's my daddy. It's my desire, Father, with every ounce that I have in me, all the energy, all the power, anything that's in me, Lord, to make you known to this generation, Lord. There's such a lost generation out there, Lord, that has a misconception, a flaw. Huh?
It's about you.
I'm sorry.
I know it's in you. You have to focus on the cross. Focus on the resurrection.
I want to make them know you, Lord. I want to make it about you, Lord, in all that I do, Lord, in all that I do.
There is a generation that cries for you.
the weirdest church I've ever been in. This is what I did all day yesterday. What God is bringing to the earth right now, it is going to take those people that are willing to lay down their life and to intercede and to cry out for Him, whether it is acceptable to our brains or not. We can't bring what heaven is birthing. Oh, Jesus came, and He came to redeem all of us, but there is such a bigger picture that He is trying to bring to the earth right now through His bride. And he's asking for His bride to be willing to do that, to be willing to be the vessels who don't care what somebody else thinks and don't have to explain it afterwards either. She's never going to have to explain this. This is biblical. He said with groanings and travailing that you're going to bring forth things. This is groaning and travailing. This is when God has desired something to come, and He's asking for those who will come and be so joined to Him, they don't care what it sounds like, looks like, or is like to other people. All they care is that they are bringing that which He desires through them to make a way for other people. This is not singular for Susan. It will affect her. You can't do that without being affected. But she's not doing it for her. She's doing it for what God is bringing for everyone else. So it's a spiritual dynamic that just happens when we draw near to Him. The Bible says that he's looking for worshipers who will worship Him in spirit and in truth. That means that get out of your soul, get out of your mind, get out of what is normal for you. The lay me down prayers, you know? The save me prayers, the rescue me prayers, okay, that's outer court stuff. That's just, you're not even in yet. You're not even in. We're at the end of the year of being all in. You can't even get in until you get all immersed. Immersed in something greater than yourself. You can't help it. When you get close to the Lord, he opens up your spiritual eyes to see everyone around you in a different way and the needs. And all you want to do, that's why it's hard for Steve not to pray for the next generation. That's why Susan started. You start caring about others. It's a natural thing that happens because you're in love with Him and He's in love with everyone. Then it's not a rule book thing. It's not a check mark thing. It's not, I didn't come to prayer so I could tell you what I did this week. Oh, help me. I didn't come to prayer. Because I need the Lord to do all these things for me. I came into the house of worship to worship and praise Him and to present thanksgiving before Him. And as I yield to that, God comes. He comes. And He's like, oh, you're a willing vessel. I know you. You're a willing vessel. And because you're willing, I'm going to show up. I'm going to show up in you. I'm going to show up through you. I'm going to bust the barriers down. I'm going to break bondages off of other people. All right. Is anybody understanding what I'm saying? Oh,
Lord, we didn't come to I announce to this body and to the body of Christ that being with you is the biggest thing. Being with you is actually the only thing. Because being with you makes us be like you. We don't want your heart to long after us anymore. We want our hearts to long after you. Oh my God. Let the Song of Solomon come alive, Lord. Let it come alive. Not an embarrassment, Lord, but a reality between the bride and the groom, Lord. Pray. Is it on? Do I have the wrong one? It's not working. That one's working.
We worship you today, God, because of who you are.
Yeah.
It's because of who you are, God. It's our heartbeat. It's for your heartbeat. Our desire, oh God, is to love you, is to worship you, is to glorify you, is to honor you, is to lift you, is to praise you, is to live for you, is to be used by you. Our hearts are open to you, God. Oh God, fill it, fill it, fill it with you, with more of you, more of your wisdom, more of your understanding, God. Fill our hearts, God, as we cry out to you, as we moan for you, as we long for you. We long for you, God. Nothing else can satisfy us but you, God. Nothing else we desire more than you, Father. It's you that we want. We want to be able to touch others, and we can't do it without you, without your presence, without you, your love radiating in us from you, without your power opening in us, using us, coming out of us to others, that bright light radiating from you to us. It is you, Lord. We look to you. We look to you. We look to you. No other we look to but you. We rend our hearts today. Our hearts today we rend to you, Father. And not our comments. It is our heart that you're desiring. It is our hearts you're desiring. We take the garment off. We take the garment off today. We take the garment off, Father, in your presence, that you will clothe us in your glory and righteousness, that we will be pleasing when we come in your presence. You will know our voice and you will show up, because our heart will be speaking and not our garments. Not how we live, not what we wear, not what we obtain. It's our hearts will be speaking to you, Father. And it will always get an answer. Yes. Yes. Our ears are attentive to you, Lord, to hear what you have to say, to hear where is our next move, to hear where are we to go, to hear what we are to say, how we are to move. Our ear is pressed to your mouth to hear, to hear, to hear, to hear. To hear in this hour what you have to say, where you want us to move, and we're willing to go. We just want to hear. We just got to hear. We press. We press, we press, we press, we press for that presence. We press to hear your voice. We press for that sound, that sound, that sound that's coming out of heaven. That sound, we press to hear that sound. That we may bring out in this generation that sound. Woo.
Father God, I just thank you that this is what she's been wanting, Lord, more of you. And so you came to pour. You came to pour. You came to pour. And so, Lord, pour. Pour more. Pour more. Oh, there it is. There it is, Lord. Oh, yeah. Oh, Jesus. There's an overflow of his presence, so don't feel like you got left out. He's here for you. And here's the rest of it for you. Here's the rest of it for you. Bucket of his desires. The bucket of his desires. Oh my goodness, oh my goodness. Help me, Jesus. Oh boy. Thank you. No. All right. Father God, I make a prophetic declaration in this house today. We are lovers of you. If that offends anybody, we are not apologizing. We're all in. We came at the beginning of this year to fight through the fray, to fight through the attacks, to fight through the retaliation But I declare the victory today. And I declare that we are all in for all time. We are all in for all time. We're not halfway in. We're not 90% in. We are immersed in loving you. We desire you above all things. Lord, we thank you for the assignment and the assignments that you've given us individually and corporately. And we thank you for it, Lord. We accept. And we're even thankful and grateful. We will not complain about the price. It pales in comparison to the price you paid. We will not complain, Lord. I break every apart of settlement where people have settled for where they have reached, where people have given themselves a pass because they're too young or they're too old or they're too tired. I break the power of that lie in Jesus' name. That they don't know how or they don't understand. I break that off you in Jesus' name. None of us know until we know. And we don't know until we're with him. And then you can't hardly say it. But we can be it to the world. And that is our desire, Lord. That is our desire. I need to take this moment to tell you what God did through you. First of all, thank you for giving to me. I got my bathroom put back together with your generosity. So I actually have walls. I didn't have walls because I had mold. My water heater broke and I had mold, so they came and they cut my walls open. And then I just had holy wall. Not the holy walls I want. Holy walls that you are embarrassed of. And so they came and they fixed that. And so thank you for that. But I appreciate that and I receive it as a gift of honor to the office that I stand in, or the offices that I stand in, prophet, pastor. But what I cried over several times this week, and even this morning, was this. Is that when we took up the offering last week and I told you that it was for Hope Center, we called them and they said, we don't know what to tell you. This has been such a year of generosity. We don't need it. All of the families were taken care of. They go, well, you could give to our general fund if you want to, but you don't have to. And we went, they called me. I go, no. We're not, I want to give where there's a need. I mean, thank God he met the need. They did have a need, but God used other people to meet it. So let's, so we prayed and I said, call Justin. He works with Sheridan House and he works with boys. How are they fulfilling the need? These are teenage boys. You know, teenage boy, everybody wants to buy baby gifts, little kid gifts, but who wants to give to the older kids? We do. Just say we do. And we did. So we gave to 15 boys. And we had money left over. Because of your generosity. Because God touched your heart. So I said, okay, Lord. We want to help our community. This is good. We want to help our community. That's good. Now what? And he goes, well, you always had a heart for the nations. I said, well, always. And so years ago, the Lord gave me a heart for India. And I thought I was going to go there. And I even tried, and my visa didn't come on time. And so, but that was God intervening, because I would have been stuck in flight in 9/11. And so the Lord did save me and Charlie and Beth. We were all going to go, we're going to change India. So, but we have changed India, because we've been a part as a church of praying for nations. And so now we sent money to orphans that Pastor Theo Sr. takes care of. And he has orphanages there. And we took care of all of their food, all of their Christmas, all of their water, everything they needed for this time. I know. I'm happy too. Thank you for clapping. I like that. I see you all the way. She's in the media room going, yay. Well, I think it's a she. Is it? Okay. Yeah, it's Susie. Okay. I can't see through those blinds. All right. But all right. So that's the generosity of God. And then I have a very important thing that I want to do today, and this may seem out of sync, but it's not. Because, as you could tell, our heart is also for generations, and everybody wanted to pray that out. Because it's on the heart of God as well. So, we get to dedicate a baby today. You guys can come up. If you can come up with the baby, oh my God, she's so beautiful. It's my favorite part. Okay. There is something about babies that just make you crazy, doesn't it? Just like everything inside you just goes melt. And so who do you want to bring up here with you? It's time. I know you thought it would never come today. You're like, this woman has forgotten us. No, I never forgot. This is important to me. It's important to the church. It's important to the world. Okay, and we're going to do that thing, Beth. At the end of this, bring the... Gotcha. Look how pretty the parents are, too. This is very photo worthy right here. All right, people take pictures. Take it with them and then take one with me, because I want to prove that I dedicated this baby. Oh my goodness, how beautiful. And then we'll take one with the whole family. Did you get them? Here, get them. Danielle's like the professional photographer. I don't know. Okay, now get one with us, because I love them. Hi, doll. And then look at the beautiful family. Okay, whoa. All the family. Come up here. And besides that, we want to look at how cute you all are. Okay. This is your mom? Come. Yeah. That's your mom? Oh, I'm so happy. Hi. Sister. Beautiful sister. Beautiful sister. How many beautiful sisters? Love you. I know you guys. All right, let me get this side. I like my hugs, you know. This is a special day. I'm glad you're here. Bless you. Hello. Okay. How many of you wish we had, what is it?
My professor from FAU.
Oh, thank you.
Aunt, I'm acting as
aunt. Oh, you're acting like aunt, but it's professional from FAU. This is awesome. Did I hug you yet? All right, I did. Hi. Look at how pretty they all are. All right. Thank you for bringing color into our lives. You know, we are pretty boring with our black, but that's okay. God knows I wear black. Oh, look, look. Okay. They're just all coming. That's all. Oh, I'm so happy, though. Yes. Okay, this is so beautiful. I love this. Now, see, this is the way it should be. Everybody's celebrating a baby? Come on now. Woo. And generation to generation? Okay, so you serve the Lord. And you raised her to serve the Lord. Oh, my goodness. And you serve the Lord. And you raised this one up. Whoa. And then they found each other. And now they're going to raise this one up. Glory, 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 hallelujah. And that's the way it goes. That's the way it's supposed to go. Okay, so why do we even do a baby dedication? You guys know this. You've heard me say this before, but all right, I'll tell them. The reason why is because these parents and these relatives know the importance of lifting this child up and making a declaration out of their mouth. This is the way this baby's life is going to be. She is going to hear the word. She is going to experience the word. She is going to experience the spirit just like today. She is going to be hungry for God. And she is going to serve him all the days of her life. Aren't you?
Yes.
You are. I know. You love me, don't you? Yes. Yes. We've been loving each other since you were in your mama's womb, haven't we? Yeah, I know. I love you so much. What would you like? Like, this is what happens. We'll give you anything. I know. Oh, my God, what a beauty. Okay, so it's an opportunity for God to bless this. You love it, don't you? You love him already. I know you do. You know, babies, that, you know, even in their mommy's womb, now they have pictures since we have all this technology where they show them praising the Lord and responding to music. They show them, you know, sucking their thumbs and moving around and I mean, it's just amazing that two people can come together and create a little creature of love that already knows him because he designed them. And so that's what he did. Praise you, the Lord. I know. It's fun, isn't it? Yeah. Yes, it is. She's a happy baby. Okay, I'm trying to stay focused. I'm not very focused, am I? Okay, I'm going to say this. say it, Susan. Iwalewa. Did I say it?
Yes.
Iwalewa. Wow. Okay, so Tasha and Talu and crew have come to dedicate this baby before the Lord. And so we make this declaration before him today. Yes, that she is going to love him and praise him at an early age and serve him. So we keep coming back to his promises concerning children, and her name means character is beauty. And isn't it true? And so the beauty of the Lord already resides inside of her, and she's going to show forth his character on this earth. You know, there's a lot of people who say they love the Lord, but they have no character. I love it that her name means beauty is character, because the most beautiful thing we can offer him is us being changed in his presence so that we present him with the character he deserves. And so I believe because you have heard from God and how to, thank you. Mommy has a look-alike thing for her. Okay. And so God named her this in the natural, but he also named her this in the spiritual. And so she's going to have the character of God that's going to be evident to other people. Okay? He told me that it's his beauty that he has instilled in the inside of her. It's his beauty. Amen? And that he created her and filled her up to hold his riches. Her middle name, which I ain't even going to try. What is it? That. Okay. That.
It's beautiful, but I can't say it. Okay, it means to enjoy the true wealth and riches. And so she's going to enjoy the wealth and riches, I believe, both ways. That means you're going to make money. But it also means we're going to enjoy the wealth and the riches of God showing up in her life. Amen? And so, and then Diana, I can say that. Did I say it right? Diana. Okay. It means divine and glorious. So you see, and I bet you she has 18 other names, does she? Yeah. I have come to learn some things from you all. And so I love that they keep naming their children more and more names because they can't contain how much they love the child. The child has a name that means this, and then it has a name that means that, and then it has a name that means that. But it's all because they're speaking those things into existence. Or maybe we need to do that. Like when we do baby dedications, we need to have 20 names for every child. I don't know. So today, we come and we dedicate this child before you, Lord. And we thank you that this is serious before your eyes. Lord, that we have come into your presence today and we have come into your house where you live, where you impart, so that you could see her in her beauty, Lord. So that you could see this dedication and you could bring her angel here to hear these words of dedication and to see to it that it is fulfilled. So, Talu and Tasha, do you promise to raise her in the fear and in the admonition of the Lord? That she will be raised knowing not just about Jesus, but knowing him in a personal way. Yes. And you will read her the word. Yes. And you will worship him with her. Yes. Now the Lord knows that you mean that. And so his hand is going to be on you for her and for your future children as well. And so she is... She is going to fully experience the joy of serving him. Amen. And so are you. She's going to train you in many ways because watching a child is an amazing thing. I got to get rid of papers. I got to hold babies. Come here, you little sweetie. Now see how we fit together oh so well. Oh my goodness, you're so beautiful. So Father, I impart, Lord, to this child, Lord, the anointing that you've put on my life. And I thank you for securing her in the future that you have for her. Lord, I thank you for the privilege of generation to generation being seen and being known in this church. And we give you praise for it, Lord. The glory belongs to you. And Lord, I bless all of these family members, Lord, that they would take this seriously. And they will do their part, Lord, to raise her up as well. Lord, we thank you that this baby dedication was right on time. As we dedicate this baby during the season where we celebrate your birth, we thank you for it in Jesus' name. Kisses from us. Everybody blow her kisses. Mm-hmm. And kisses from heaven, too. All right. All right, parents. All right, now the reason why I had them bring the kids in, you can stay up here if you want, because are they here, Cindy? All right. Would you come up here? They'll come up here by me. I like them. My babies. God's babies. When I was praying about this today, I knew that we were going to come to do this for you all. So you don't mind if I take advantage of this moment, do you?
Because how many of you know that all of these children, whatever age they are just as important to all of us? And I know these kids, and I've dedicated most of them to the Lord in this church, but I feel like we need to understand the importance of generation to generation. The dedication that we need to give as a people group, she belongs to them, but how many of you know she belongs to us? It's a part of what the church is supposed to be. How many of you know that they have parents? But they belong to us. This is part of our responsibility as spiritual leaders, spiritual Christians, just spiritual Christians, to parent those that are among us. There's not supposed to be this disconnect of age groups. There's not to be a disconnect of our hearts and how we love. And so, you know, we love, like, okay, who's the oldest? Kayla? Isn't she beautiful? We love you. We love you so much. And this is our youngest up here today. Well, besides our baby. And this is Matthew. And everybody in between. And we know that we love them all. But when I'm praying, and you too, even though you're sitting over there, when I'm praying, I don't think about one child in this house. They're all in here. The teenagers are in here. The young adults are in here. You young adults live inside of me too. And then the adults, they crowd right in. And so we're carriers of his love for a purpose. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. And so I want to just dedicate the generations today. I want to dedicate and rededicate and redeclare the truth about how God feels over these generations. And so we're going to do that right now. Father God, we come as a church body. And we come with the seriousness of what you have put inside of our heart. Lord, you have called us to show families how to be families. You have called us to be the family for those who don't have the right kind of family. And so, Lord, from generation to generation, I make this declaration that today, as a day of dedicating ourselves before you, as we worshiped you, as we praised you, as we prayed to you, as we cried out to you, as we brought forth new things in the Spirit, Lord, we bring forth this dedication of generation to generation to generation, Lord. I thank you that your hand is always on this and you are always in the midst of this, because this is your idea, and that is why the church is still alive. Lord, I thank you for generation after generation that your name has been known and has been declared, and we declare it again into the hearts and the lives of each one of these children, that they are dedicated unto you. They are dedicated unto living for you, that every child in this house, every teenager in this house, every young adult in this house, and every adult in this house will serve you, and they will take this ceremony seriously. Lord, I thank you that you have come today. You didn't just come as a baby in a manger, but we're really glad you did. And then you released heaven for us to live it out on earth. So, Father, let us take care of one another. Let there be a melting between generations, not separations anymore. Let there be no more segmentation, Lord. Not of color, not of age, not of creed, not of any kind of friction that the enemy has brought in the past. Lord, between political opinions or Father, we smash it. We smash it. None of it matters. We are children of the Most High God. And we declare this as a dedication ceremony before you, to love you, to serve you, and to help each other as spiritual helpers, as spiritual fathers, as spiritual mothers, as spiritual Christians. And we thank you for the end result that will bring glory to your name. We thank you for it. We thank you for it, Jesus. Amen and amen. All right. Yay, Jesus, right? I do have to say they're all very cute, aren't they? They're beautiful. All of you are cute, too, just in case you wondered. All right. I love you.
We love you.
But who do we love the most?
Jesus.
And who are we going to serve the most? Oh, okay. And who are we going to give to the most? With every part of us. Mind, soul, spirit, body, and money. So it's time for the offering. They're waving offering plates back there. This is never on the top of my agenda, but it is necessary. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Did you get something out of the service today? Thank you. Thank you, worship people. Yay. Love you, love you, love you. Appreciate you. Come, let us adore him. Hallelujah. Drinda, you should be all healed by the end of this week. Help her in the meantime. Jesus, thank you. We give you praise, Lord. We give you praise, Lord, even for our ability to give. We thank you, Lord, that you deserve everything that we have. And God, I pray that we would be willing to be those vessels that whatever you told us to write out, we would be willing to do that. Lord, I just thank you that you offered everything to us. Now this is just a small part of us offering back to you. So Lord, it's a joy for us to give. It's a joy to help those kids. It's such a joy for us, Lord. And it's a joy to minister to you by letting you see our hearts of wanting to give to your house, wanting to give to the place where you come and present yourself to us today. We are so grateful, Lord. We want to give you an offering to thank you. Lord, not just with words, Lord, but with that which represents our everyday life, our hard work. Piece of us for all of you. Oh, it's not even a fair exchange, but we count it an honor, Lord. And so we honor you with this offering today. And I thank you for multiplying it back to these households, Lord. Multiply it back, Lord, to the overflow so that we can help more people. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, ushers, wait on the people. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Well, it's Christmas time. I know I'm not preaching out of Luke. Maybe next week. Maybe. We don't know. So, you know, there's a whole lot of stuff in the Bible that I wanted to share. A whole lot of stuff about why God does what he does and how he laid it out in the Old Testament and how it looks in the New Testament. And someday I'll teach you that teaching about the tabernacle. But here's a couple things that you need to know is that, let's see, where is, I don't even know if I kept the announcements, did I? No. Are they there? Yeah. This is what is going to happen. The Christmas service, we're having a Christmas service here on December 23rd, obviously. This will be when we actually, next Sunday. I'll probably actually talk about, you know, the book of Luke. We'll see. Or maybe he'll just show up again. We don't care. All right. And then Sunday, December 30th is going to be our New Year's service. So we usually have a New Year's Eve service. So those of you that have joined us for New Year's Eve service before, if you come on New Year's Eve, I won't be here. So I'm actually going to be in town. But when I looked at who would be gone and I recognized the value of what you need to hear, a lot of people don't come on New Year's Eve because it's late. They don't come and they're uncomfortable with their kids and blah, blah, blah. So you're going to hear, I'm going to prophesy, what a surprise,
But I will prophesy out the word of the Lord for 2019. So if you want to know what God is saying to us for 2019, do not miss December 30th at 10 a.m. That's our regular Sunday service, but it won't be regular. Amen? Say our New Year's service will be celebrated December 30th at 10 a.m. Yeah. And so then you'll know what God is saying for 2019, and then we will get ourselves in order. And one of the ways we get ourselves in order is that in January, we will start our fast. Now, not January 2nd, but the following week. Do we know the 8th? Okay. So we'll start it, and it's 21 days. So for those of you who've never fasted, I'll be letting you know what this is about. But we're going to fast because we are going to kill this flesh. You are going down. And the Spirit is going to rise as we set aside our time to focus on Him. So we have a teaching, and we have scriptures, we have worship, and we will come into unity by doing this. So I hope you'll all be a part of that. And so I've been working very diligently on getting the fasting guide ready for you. And all of us have to work hard on doing it, because I write it, but then everybody else has to correct all of my bad grammar and punctuation and run-on sentences and put it together and make me look good. So when you go, "Oh, that's so awesome," then you'll go, "She had a lot of help." And she did. Yeah, she did. But it's the heart of God that we're after. Amen? And so when we go through it, I just pray that you'll take it as seriously as I do when I'm writing it, because I know God is doing something amazing for us. Amen? Okay. Be gone. Be blessed.